Hi, in today's video, I'll show you how to make a simple gate drive circuit based on the TL494 passive modulation IC, which you can use to control a half bridge or a full hedge bridge for a switch mode power supply or an inverter. The circuit is really simple and straightforward. To begin with, the oscillator frequency is set to about 42 kHz. Of course, it can be customized to any value. Capacitor C1 and the resistor R1 are responsible for the frequency. The formula is given by 1 R over 2 times RT CT, with RT being R1 and CT being C1, with 1 nanofarad and 12 kilo ohms in gate 42 kHz as shown. This is good for a high frequency switch mode power supply or a power inverter in which you need a ferrite core transformer. For 50 Hz, you need to change the values for C1 and R1 as shown. The IC has two air amplifiers which can be used for feedback. You can use this to monitor the output voltage and regulate the output voltage. You can also adjust the output duty cycle by providing a voltage at the dead time pin form. Any voltage from 0 to 3.3 volts will increase the dead time from 0 to 100%. Therefore, by providing a voltage feedback at this pin, you can adjust the maximum duty cycle that can be achieved by the output drive transistors. Connect the capacitor C2 and resistor 9 as shown. This basically is a compensation network which will ensure that the output does not change erratically with variations in the load. You need to provide a reference voltage for the air amplifiers. This is an example whereby you provide a reference voltage of 2.5 volts, the reference pin 14 generates 5 volts and can output a maximum of 5 milliamps. And by connecting two resistors across pin 14 and ground, you can set a midpoint of 2.5 volts and use this to provide a reference voltage to the air amplifiers. You can adjust the resistors or even use two divider networks for specific reference voltages for each of the air amplifier. To set the output drive transistors as a push-pull driver, you also need to put the output control pin 13 to 5 volts by connecting it to pin 14. Pin 12 is VCC and 7 is ground as shown. The open connectors are pin 8 and 11, and the emitters are 9 and 10, which are pulled down to ground. The open connectors are pulled up to VCC, which should be at least 15 volts and 1.5 amperes, by 2 watts 230 ohms resistors as shown. Because the IC can output a maximum of about 200 milliamps, this is not sufficient to drive a high frequency switch mode power supply, and therefore you need a current boost. In this case, I've used the BD-9 and BD-40 complementary bipolar transistors to do this. This can boost the output drive currents up to about 1 ampere without a problem. The connections to the transistors are as shown. The open connectors are connected to the NPN and the PNP as shown. Assuming that the first transistor is on, meaning that this pin 8 will be pulled down to ground, the transistor Q4 will conduct and Q3 will be off. At the same time, because this is off, there will be a VCC reference at this point, and so Q2 will be off and Q1 will be on. This will allow current to flow from VCC through the transistor Q1, through the primary winding of the gate drive transformer, and through the transistor Q4 to ground. When the first transistor turns off and the second transistor turns on, there will be a ground reference here, and so this will conduct and Q1 will turn off. Q4 will also turn off, but Q3 will conduct, allowing current to flow from VCC through the resistor array, through the primary winding of the transformer, through Q2 and to ground as shown. This completely reverses the waveform at the primary of the gate drive transformer, and so by using additional windings, you can connect this to the gate and sources of any MOSFET that you want to turn them on and off. The gate drive can be a toroidal transformer with an iron pounded core or even a ferrite core transformer. The windings usually should be about the same for the primary and each of the secondaries, like you can have 12 turns for the primary and 12 turns for each of the secondaries. The connections are denoted by the dot as shown, assuming you have wound all the windings in the same direction, with the dots indicating the start point. The connections to the gate of each MOSFET are shown. Connect the first MOSFET as shown and the second MOSFET as shown. This will ensure that the MOSFET Q5 and Q6 will conduct at different times, and this can prevent current shoot through, which could have occurred if the MOSFETs conducted at the same time and shorten the high voltage directly to the negative rail. This is a demonstration of a simple half bridge topology, and from here you can continue to the power transformer, which is usually a ferrite core transformer and a half bridge made up of capacitors. You can also have 4 windings on the secondary side and 2 more MOSFETs to make a full H bridge. Just ensure that you carefully note the sequence and wind them correctly. Hopefully you have enjoyed this video, and if so, don't forget to give it a like, share with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Have a nice time.